Hello, friends. Let me ask you a question first. If you could have any superpower, what would you choose? For most of us, it'll definitely be invisibility. Just think about it for a second. You can do anything without being observed. However, the real question is it a gift or a curse? Martin, a boy from South Africa, living with his parents and two siblings, had a normal life, just like most of us. As a child, he was obsessed with electronics and sports and would spend hours doing so. One day, he came back from school, complaining of a sore throat. His symptoms were becoming more serious. As the time passed, he got headaches and seizures. His physical and mental health was getting worse day after day. What's surprising is, doctors were unable to find the cause of his illness. There was no diagnosis. After a month had passed, he lost the ability to walk or even speak. He was completely paralyzed and stopped making eye contact. It turns out he had tuberculosis of the brain, and eventually he was in a virtual coma, unaware of his surroundings. He was completely unresponsive. Muscles and limbs were wasted. Hands and feet curled in on themselves like claws. He was in a virtual coma, but the doctors could not diagnose what had caused it. Martin was treated for tuberculosis and meningitis, but no precise diagnosis was made. Treatment after treatment had no effect. His condition was difficult for doctors to understand, as he was lost in his brain and could not be rescued. After months of tests and treatments, the doctors told his parents that nothing seemed to be working. The only option was to take him back home and let this mysterious illness run its course. Later, Martin wrote, "Politely but firmly, the medical profession washed its hands of me. In fact, we were told to wait until my death released us all." Once Martin was home, his father would wake up early in the morning to drive his son to a special care center, pick him up after 8 hours, feed him, bathe him, and put him to bed. This place was Martin's worst nightmare since he was treated badly. But after 4 years of helplessness, a miracle occurred. He was aware of everything. It turns out his mind woke up and he became aware of his surroundings. But still, even after he got control over his mental facilities, his body could not move, nor could he say a word. As Martin said later, "My father's faith in me was stretched almost to a breaking point. My dad washed, fed, dressed, and lifted me. I would try my best to make him notice. I could see and hear, but failed to communicate. He continued to undress me. I tried to move my arm, but it was not moving. I took a deep breath, and my father said, 'Are you okay, boy?' as he heard my deep breath and saw my face. I could only stare, praying my silent desperation would speak to him. 'Let's get you into bed, shall we?' Dad said. I gradually became aware of each day and each hour in it. Most were forgettable, but there were times I saw history unfold. I knew who I was and where I was. I was completely helpless. At first, I wanted to fight my fate by leaving some tiny sign to guide people back to me. However, how much I tried to beg, shout, and scream, I could not make them notice me. Losing every hope, Martin decided to switch off his thoughts and go back to his dark world. His parents left him in front of the television for hours, playing endless episodes of Barney and Friends, to an extent that he was fed up. He said, "I cannot even express to you how much I hated Barney." His mother was extremely sad and frustrated by seeing her son so helpless. She even tried to take her own life by overdosing on pills. Luckily, she was taken to the hospital in time. Hurt by his mother's feelings, he pulled himself out of the darkness he was planning to go back to. He became more kind towards his parents, knowing their state and what they had to go through. He began by teaching himself how to tell time by the rays of sun floating across the room. He tried again and again, as hard as he could, to let everyone know that he is back in his body. Martin met a caregiver at the center, who was really kind to him. She noticed a repetitive motion made by him over certain phrases and questions. She told the main caregiver about his motion, After intense examination, the workers agreed that he was aware of his surroundings. Martin was able to move his body more and more with therapy. His mind also became more and more powerful. His determination grew, and he amazed caretakers by quickly gaining more and more emotion, proving those who believed he would never respond again were wrong. Doctors found out he suffered a disease called locked-in syndrome, in which even a small movement like eye contact also becomes inactive. It's a rare disease, and recovery is almost impossible. However, Martin proved this wrong through his will and determination. He not only regained mobility for most parts of his body, but he was also able to communicate through a computer. It was a gift from his parents to help him talk to them. As the time passed, with his hard work, he was back in a wheelchair, gaining more and more knowledge to understand how to speak and to be able to communicate with others. Years passed, and Martin quickly adapted to his new life. He went on to get a job at a government office. He joined a university to study computer science and eventually started his own company. He also learned how to drive a car. In 2008, Martin met Joanna, a friend of his sister, who found him very attractive. For this couple, it was love at first smile. Martin flew to the UK where Joanna lived and proposed to her. They got married in a ceremony in 2009 and currently live in England. That's it, guys. Our inspirational story ends here. Please let me know in the comment section below what you think of it. Before going anywhere, make sure to hit that subscribe button and smash the bell icon to never miss a good story again. I hope you enjoyed this video. See you next time!